All right, so here we have some interior panels I'm making for my Wagoneer. Excuse me. So I used the original panels, which I had most of the original panels, and I just laid them out on some FRP, which is the material I'm using here. And I traced it out. And then I cut oversize of my traces. And now I'm test fitting these panels. So this one, I've already final trimmed almost all the other sides. But the top was kind of tall, so I went through and marked in yellow my final cut mark. So I'm going to do that with this Beverly shear here. This works really well for cutting this FRP. It does leave some rough edges, which you could sand out or whatever, but for the time being, I'm not too worried about it. But I'm going to start cutting this a little bit. See if I can get a couple shots. Probably won't be able to do this very well with the camera in my hand, but so the black marks were the original trace that I got off of the panel, and if you can see, there's some black marks to the left and some to the right of the yellow line, which is my final dimension. So my old panels were pretty crusty. The vinyl had shrunk considerably, so the cardboard behind the vinyl had distorted. So I couldn't get a really accurate measurement. And then for the panels that I was missing, I used some foam material. It's like a rolled out foam material, kind of like the stuff they use under laminate floors. In fact, I think I had a roll of that when I pulled the laminate out of my kitchen and put in tile. So I saved the laminate and I used it. Actually, that was the same thing I used to do all of my floors with in my Jeep. I just rolled that stuff out and traced out the dimensions that I wanted to, and transferred them onto a sheet of 18 gauge. But anyways, so for the panels I didn't have, I used some foam. And then for the panels I did have, I laid them over the FRP, traced them. And then I cut oversize, and right now I'm going to cut this final dimension in yellow. So pause this and I'll show you the fitment or where it's going to be going here. Alright, so this is the back cargo container, cargo area. And this piece I was cutting, it goes right here above the rear driver's side wheel well. And this was a two-piece part because it allows you to remove this larger panel, and I think, you know, there was some service area like for jacks and stuff like that. So this piece typically stayed stationary, and still a little too tight. I got too much material in between these two points, so it's not sliding forward all the way, but for the most part I just want to show you that the Beverly shear is what I use to cut this FRP out. And this stuff is sandable and paintable. It's got two sides. It's got this textured side, and then it's got a smooth side on the back. Now my plan was to use this as a replacement for the cardboard, and then I was gonna material wrap this. Now if I do, I'm gonna need some some looser tolerances so that when I put these panels back in place with material around them, they'll still fit. But right now I cut them tight so that for the time being, these are all I'm going to use. This truck is far from pretty or nice. It's just something that I'm trying to make a little bit better. So in the meantime, this will do for now.